Skeletal remains found in the 18th century wreck of the pirate ship off the coast of Cape Cod. Researchers believe that one of the Weddell skeletons might belong to the legendary pirate Samuel "Black Sam" Bellamy. These skeletal remains of six pirates have been found at the site of a historic shipwreck off the coast of Cape Cod and might lead to the discovery of legendary pirate Samuel "Black Sam" Bellamy. The discovery was announced by the Wyda Pirate Museum in West Yarmouth, Massachusetts. The museum, which takes its name from the doomed ship, now has the pirate bones on display. Bellamy and the crew infamously lost their lives when their stolen ship, the Wyda Galley, sank off Wellfleet during a treacherous storm in April 1717. Of the 146 pirates on board, only two survived. The bodies of 101 washed up on shore, and the 43 who were unaccounted for, which included Bellamy, likely went down with the ship. The skeletons were found in what's known as a concretion, which is a mass of stone and sand that's melded together over centuries underwater. One of these skeletons might belong to Bellamy, whose body has never been found, as well as reveal the personal histories of his pirate crew. We hope that modern, cutting-edge technology will help us identify these pirates and reunite them with any descendants who could be out there. Underwater explorer Barry Clifford, who originally discovered the wreck in 1984, said, "In that regard, Clifford and his team already hold one possible key, DNA. Casey Sherman, a lead investigator for the Wyda team, tracked down a descendant of Bellamy's in Devonshire, England in 2018. The descendant eagerly offered over his own DNA to use in comparison. These newly found skeletal remains may finally lead us to Bellamy," Sherlin confirmed. "These skeletons now offer a sample to be tested against the DNA of Bellamy's descendant. Investigators are hopeful that the lack of oxygen underwater help preserve any DNA samples that remain in the 300-year-old bones." Clifford's team is especially optimistic that one of the skeletons could belong to Bellamy because a pistol was found nearby that likely belonged to Bellamy himself. Before Wyda was stolen by Bellamy and his crew, however, it functioned as a slave ship. The pirates captured the vessel during its maiden voyage. Wyda had dropped off a consignment of slaves in Jamaica and was headed back to England with the money from the sale of those slaves, explained Clifford. By the time the ship sank, it not only contained gold from the slave trade, but also valuables from the 50 or so ships that had been raided by Bellamy and his men. More than 15,000 coins have been recovered so far. To date, the Wyda remains the only authenticated pirate wreck in the world. Meanwhile, investigators continue to painstakingly analyze concretions, while further artifacts are still nestled deep in the Atlantic Ocean. The Wyda Pirate Museum also notes that shackles used to bind slaves were recovered from the shipwreck, and they tell an important story about the slave trade itself. Finds like this, the museum says, are very important as living links or touchstones to an extraordinarily tragic episode in human history. Clifford agrees. "This shipwreck is very sacred ground," he said. "We know a third of the crew was of African origin, and the fact that they robbed the Wyda, which was a slave ship, presents them in a whole new light." To Clifford's point, some historians believe that despite their penchant for crime, pirates practice egalitarianism and racial democracy among their crews. In fact, Black Sam Bellamy had a reputation for treating his crew equally, regardless of their origin, and letting the men vote on important decisions. Bellamy's way of doing things had little time to catch on, however. His career as a pirate only lasted a year before he died in the wreck. As for now, Clifford and other investigators hope that the wreck of the Wyda will continue to offer up treasures about the history of life on the high seas. The world is filled with stories going viral every single day. But how many of these sites can you actually follow? We understand that your day should start with positive stories, stories that resonate with you. And so we started JoJo Stories. Our mission is to create meaningful stories that cover everything from animals to anthropology, history to environment and lifestyle. The kind of content you read on our site will be one you'll want to share with your family and friends. We hope you'll join our growing family and be part of our community.
Welcome to JoJo Stories. JoJoStories.com.